A single drone zooms in on the fierce sight of 8 jet skis tearing through the waves toward the Crimean coast, each piloted by 2 brave frogmen. As darkness deepens, the only guide is the faint torchlight illuminating their path. Soldiers alight, the roar of engines now replaced with palpable tension, up until it's interrupted by an act of defiance. These warriors, in unwavering unity, thrust the blue and yellow Ukrainian flag into the sand. Within hours, GUR's Twitter erupts, proudly showcasing the valor of its special force. Their message was clear. The daring raid on Russian-occupied Crimea was just the beginning, hinting at a resurgence, chanting, quote, "Crimea will be Ukrainian." The geopolitical landscape was shaken as GUR released this electrifying footage, heralding the heroism of its elite operatives. On August 24th, Ukraine's second Independence Day after the full-scale invasion, the world's media was ablaze with reports of a daring raid, accompanied by compelling video evidence. The mission, spanning a perilous 265-mile round trip across the stormy Black Sea, saw 20 Ukrainian frogmen transported by 10 jet skis. In September 2023, the Times of London painted a vivid picture. 10 jet skis gliding under a moonless sky, silently navigating the vast waters toward the Crimean coast. This marked the historical return of Ukrainian soldiers to Crimea, a place they hadn't treaded in nearly a decade. The strategic mind behind the operation was a battalion commander known only as Borghese. He vividly remembers the hushed ambience as they reached a beach close to the village of Olenivka in Crimea, with the first light of dawn still hours away. The mission's objective was sharp and focused: penetrate a Russian base to dismantle a critical electronic warfare station. Such was the station's potency that compasses within a 20-mile vicinity would go awry. It had been a significant obstacle, neutralizing drone operations and even tracking the flight path of British Storm Shadow missiles. As the unit neared the peninsula, a diversion was in play. 5 Ukrainian support ships launched an assault on Russian outposts. But in the shadowed proximity of their goal, the Ukrainian squad's secrecy unraveled, plunging them into a fierce encounter. The operation wasn't without its hitches. At a critical juncture, a mere 200 meters from their target, one of the Ukrainian teams was detected. Forced to adapt quickly, they launched their anti-tank weapons and rocket-propelled grenades instead of sticking to the initial plan. Borghese vividly remembered their mission, intended to infiltrate the control center, plant explosives, and leave discreetly. But the sudden clash changed the course of action. They chose to remotely incapacitate the control center and its antennae, preparing for a swift retreat. Yet escape was far from easy. Russian aircraft and naval vessels were on their heels. An entire stretch of the Black Sea lay between the Ukrainian raiders and safety, a vast expanse where Russian warplanes and Raptor patrol boats relentlessly pursued them. As dawn approached, Levan, the second in command, signaled for withdrawal. The journey was perilous. Every moment exposed them to naval and aerial threats. Just when their situation seemed most dire, Ukrainian support vessels intervened. With a fierce volley of anti-aircraft missiles, they held the enemy at bay. The pursuit was intense. Russian aircraft shadowed them for what felt like an eternity. It was unyielding. But then nature played its hand. A veil of clouds concealed the Ukrainians, and eventually, the warm embrace of the sun signified a new day and their safe passage. The GUR, Ukraine's Defense Intelligence Directorate, would mark this as one of many successful operations. But the conflict and retaliations haven't ceased. In the quiet hum of an ordinary Wednesday in early October 2023, the GUR released footage that sent shockwaves through the global stage. This brief video, just over a minute long, sketches a compelling scene. Jet skis slice through the waves, each bearing 2 men, rapidly approaching the coastlines of the Russian-controlled Crimean Peninsula. As the clip reaches its climax, Ukrainian soldiers, their nation's flag aloft, firmly proclaim, "Crimea remains and shall always be Ukrainian." This display is credited to 2 distinct units, Shtugna and Brotherhood, both under the umbrella of the Timur Special Unit within the GUR. Intriguingly, the name chosen for the unit hints at a spiritual facet to their mission, as recruitment posters call for battle swimmers rooted in a belief in God. Not long after, the GUR took to Twitter, extolling their valiant efforts, describing the significant blow they dealt to the, quote, Moscow occupiers. The triumphant statement read, quote, "Our state flag flew once more over Ukrainian Crimea, shedding light on a special operation characterized by combat, demolition of military equipment, and enemy losses." GUR spokesperson Andriy Yusov verified the operation's recency, but sidestepped direct questions about a purportedly detained soldier. Still, his fervent response seems to confirm the rumor, stressing Ukraine's unwavering resolve to recover any apprehended personnel. While the Russian Defense Ministry opted for silence regarding the footage, Crimea's Russian-appointed leader, Sergei Aksenov, did acknowledge the incident. Through a telegram message, he conveyed his gratitude to the FSB Border Service for thwarting an infiltration attempt. Although he kept specifics under wraps, Aksenov did reveal the capture and ongoing questioning of a potential saboteur. Not to be outdone, the official Russian RIA Novosti news agency chimed in, sharing what they asserted was an interrogation video of a detained Ukrainian saboteur. The news agency offered further insights, suggesting that the mission involved 16 operatives with the goal of securing footage from the peninsula. Faced with these claims, Yusov simply responded, quote, "We do not comment on Russian propaganda." In a conversation with Euromaidan Press, Yusov painted a complex picture. While acknowledging Ukrainian casualties, he emphasized that these paled in comparison to the damage dealt to Russian forces. Moreover, Yusov drew attention to the multiple Ukrainian operative teams strategically positioned along Crimea's western coast. Ukraine's audacity initially raised eyebrows among allies, including the British SAS. Yet these operations not only lifted Ukrainian spirits, but also set the stage for a series of successful offensives against key Russian assets in Crimea. The peninsula's strategic role in the conflict cannot be overstated, serving as Russia's primary base for relentless air raids on Ukrainian soil. Levan, reflecting on the impact of his group's mission, shared, quote, "I'm proud of my guys, the courage of our fighters, and their incredible physical training. You can see that after we landed on the peninsula, a lot of interesting things started to happen there. I can tell you that this mission triggered all of this. It worked to make the enemy more vulnerable. We now have the means to plan and execute even larger operations. There's a lot more to come." As the tides of conflict shift, Ukraine introduces new tools to its arsenal. The Marichka underwater drone stands out, primed to challenge Russia's grip on Crimea and target pivotal structures, such as the 3 billion-pound Kerch Bridge. The situation continues to escalate, with attacks and counterattacks. But amid all the claims and counterclaims, the truth remains elusive. While the Ukrainian GUR asserts its successful raids on Crimea, the tangible results and the authenticity of the events remain subjects of debate. As with most geopolitical conflicts, the narratives often blur, and discerning fact from fiction becomes an intricate task. However, in this shifting battleground, Ukraine's commandos, equipped with jet skis, courage, and the advantage of surprise, have undeniably marked themselves as worthy adversaries.